गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू स्टडी टाइम। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न ग्रामर पार्ट फ्रेजेस। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय फ्रेजेस? फ्रेजेस आर यूनिट्स ऑफ लैंग्वेज दैट वी यूज ऑल द टाइम। नाउ लेट्स सी डेफिनेशन एंड एग्जांपल्स। नाउ लुक एट दिस पिक्स। यू कैन सी हियर सम पिक्स एंड वर्ड्स आर मेंशन हियर। फर्स्टली वी विल क्लियर द डेफिनेशन। सी phrases. Phrases means a group of two or more words functioning as a meaningful unit within a sentence or clause. Okay. Now look at these pics. Here pics are shown here. Okay. And small words means short words are given here, like the tiny mouse, was reading, very tall, only occasionally, on the table. Okay. So what is it? These all are phrases. Means a phrase is a group of words. It can be short or long, but it doesn't include the subject or verb. For example, in the school. So this is the phrase. It doesn't have any subject, otherwise verb. Second one, on the wall. Here also only some words are mentioned here. Okay, it's called a phrase. Let's clear the phrases with more examples. Phrases means a group of two or more grammatically linked words that do not have subject and predicate. It's a phrase. For example, excellent idea, great job. Noun. Noun means a naming word. Let's see the noun with definition and examples. Definition of noun. A noun is a naming word. It can be the name of a person, place, or thing. For example, women, pen, pencil, hotel, Taj Mahal, etc. Now let's learn about adjective. Adjective. An adjective is a word that describes a noun or a pronoun. For example, look here in this picture. Sophie is a clever girl. Here clever is an adjective and it describes Sophie. Look at this question A. One has been done for you. For example, king is a noun, so adjective and phrases they have given, like good and wise. So phrases is a good and wise king. Now second one have to solve, soldier. What will come? From the story we have to write. The soldier was cruel and miser, we know. So here have to write cruel, comma, miser. So what phrases will come? Yes, a cruel and miser master. Third, horse, strong and magnificent. These all both are the adjectives. Means this strong and magnificent, these both words describe about the horse, how he was. Yes, he was excellent and strong. Now what phrases will come? A strong and magnificent horse. Yes. Next question, rope. How was the rope? We have to describe it. So when we will describe the about rope, so it will be adjective, long and strong. And what's the phrase? A long and strong rope. Fifth question, leaves. How were the leaves? Yes, leaves were green and fresh. So fresh and green leaves. Eyes. How were the eyes of that horse? Dim and weak. So dim and weak were adjective. And so what phrases will come? Dim and weak eyes. Learn these adjective and phrases and do practice in notebook. Now let's solve question B, phrases. Fill in the blanks. Use the phrases from the boxes. Okay. I'm going to read the options. Listen it carefully. You have to give me the answer. Which option is suitable for which question? In a hurry. Second option. Full of flowers. Third, a crowded bus. Crowded bus means of a space full of people. Fourth, with ease. Ease means without any effort. Otherwise, you can say mastery over it very easily. Next option, for a long time. Next, good and wise. A deafening sound. Deafening sound means very loud noise. Last option, kind and caring. Now, let's solve the questions. Agastya gave his seat to an old man in dash. Which option will be suit here? Yes, a crowded bus. Agastya gave his seat to an old man in a crowded bus. Next question. The bomb exploded and caused.
dash, okay, a deafening sound. The bomb exploded and caused a deafening sound, means a loud, very loud noise. Third question, the dash nurse spoke gently to the patients. Yes, kind and caring. The kind and caring nurse spoke gently to the patient. Question fourth, the clever detective solved the case dash. Which phrase will come here? With ease. Okay, the clever detective solved the case with ease, means very easily, without any effort. Otherwise, they were having the mastery over it. Next question, the valley was dash. Which phrase is correct over here? Full of floods. The valley was full of floods. Sixth question, King John was dash and his people loved him. So correct phrase is here, good and wise. King John was good and wise and his people loved him. Question number 7. Veena left the party dash. Which phrase will suit here? In a hurry. Yes, correct. Veena left the party in a hurry. Last question. Rupal, you have been sleeping dash. Yes, only one phrase is left over here. Which one it is? For a long time.
Learn phrases and fill in the blanks.
Now let's learn homophones. Homophones are words that sound the same but have a different meaning. For example, you can see in this picture. M-A-I-L, male. M-A-L-E, male. Pronunciation is same but spelling and meaning is totally different. Next picture. D-O-E and D-O-U-G-H, doe. Third picture. P-A-I-R, P-E-A-R, pair. Fourth picture, W-H-O-L-E, H-O-L-E, whole. See in the textbook, example has been given. O-N-E-1 dash W-O-N-1. Both pronunciation is same, but spelling is different and meaning also different. Let's see with pick example. Now look at this pick. What is it? One. O-N-E-1. For example, I have one pencil. Now see this pic. Everyone is happy here. Okay? Why they were happy? Because they won the match. W-O-N-1. For example, India won the World Cup match in 1983 and 2011. Now let's solve the questions. Fill in the blanks. Choose the correct word from the brackets. Question. The whale is a huge creature that lives in the dash. S-E-E-C or S-E-A-C. You have to tell me answer. I will show both pictures to you. With the help of it, you can give the correct answer. Now look at this pic. What's it? Yes, large water body. Okay, it's called a sea. Next pic. What is it? This pick of eyes. Yes, S-E-E-C. It helps us to see. Now tell me which option is correct here. S-E-E-C or S-E-A-C. Yes, second option is correct. Okay, the whale is a huge creature that lives in the sea. S-E-A-C. Now second question. We had to eat dash plain or plain bread for lunch. Okay, pronunciation is same here. P-L-A-N-E, plain, and P-L-A-I-N, plain. Now let's see, with the help of picture, you will get it which option is correct. Now look at this. What is it? Yes, it's a plain surface. P-L-A-N-E, plain means a flat surface. Next pick, see it. Yes, food has been given here. Okay, simple food like rice and vegetable. P-L-A-I-N, plain. Yes, you might have judged what's the answer. P-L-A-N-E, plain, or P-L-A-I-N, plain. We had to eat dash bread for lunch. Plain bread for lunch. P-L-A-I-N, plain. Okay, third option. Question, the cook kneaded the dough to make bread.
Here, see, the spelling is given like D-O-U-G-H and D-O-E, dough. Let's see with example. Now look at this pic. This is dough, okay? D-O-U-G-H. It's a mixture of water and flour and salt. Second picture, doe. What is it? A female deer. Now guess the answer. What will come? Listen it carefully. The cook kneaded the dough to make bread. D-O-U-G-H, dough. Mixture of flour, water and salt. Now question number fourth. The minister made a dash with the neighboring countries. Options are given here. Pact, P-A-C-T, pact, and P-A-C-K-E-D, pact. Pronunciation is same. So which option will be correct? Let's see the example. Now look at this pic. What this pic tells us? Yes, it's an agreement. P-A-C-T, pact. Pact means a formal agreement between individual parties, otherwise in countries. Now next pic, what it is? Pact, P-A-C-K-E-D. It means filled. For example, see this bag, traveling bag. Yes, my bag is packed. I am ready to go. Question number fifth. My sister and her friend went on a cruise around the world. Okay, which cruise will come? C-R-E-W-S or C-R-U-I-S-E? Let's see. Look at this pic. Peoples are working together. Okay, C-R-E-W. Cruise. Cruise means a group of people who work together, for example on ship, otherwise aircraft. Next pick, C-R-U-I-S-E, cruise. Cruise means what? A travel on a ship or boat. So which option is correct over here? Think and tell me. Same question, we are going to repeat it once again. My sister and her friends went on a cruise around the world. C-R-U-I-S-E. This second option will be correct. Why? Because it's the meaning travel on a ship or boat. Now let's see the next example. Question number 6. Meera bought cheap clothes at the Dash market. Yes, I know answer is flea. You're also thinking flea. But which one option is correct? F-L-E-A correct or F-L-E-E correct? Let's see. Now look at this pic. Yes, the man. What he is doing? He's running. Okay. F-L-E-E, flee. Flee means run away from a place or situations. Example. Why does he always flee any kind of responsibility? Next pic. Flea market. Okay. Flea market means what? A street market which is selling second-hand goods. So think and tell me which option is correct over here. Yes, correct option is F-L-E-A, flea market. Okay, Meera bought a cheap clothes at the Dash market. F-L-E-A, flea market. Now next question, question number 7. After walking for an hour, everyone took a dash. B-R-A-K-E, break, or B-R-E-A-K, break. Okay, two options are given here. Let's see which option will be correct. Now look at this pic. Three types of breaks are shown over here. Okay, B-R-A-K-E, brake. Brake means a device for slowing or stopping a moving vehicle. Next type of B-R-E-A-K, brake means what? A pause in a work. For example, see in the pic, time for lunch. It's also brake. Now what's the answer here? Yes, B-R-E-A-K, brake. See the same question once again. After walking for an hour, everyone took a break. B-R-E-A-K. Second option is correct. Question number 8. We should try not to dash water. W-A-S-T-E, west, or W-A-R-S-T, west. Which option is correct over here? Let's see. See the pic? Yes. W-A-R-S-T. See the difference in between. W-A-R-S-T, west. West means the part of the body below the ribs. Second pick, W-A-S-T-E, waste means some people's using water carelessly. So we can say, do not waste water. Now see here, which answer is correct? Option first, W-A-S-T-E,
We should try not to waste water. WASTE. Next question. Question number 9. The children were told to wear dash on the day of the hiking trip. Okay. What's the meaning of hiking over here? Yes, it means the activity for long walk. So which type of jeans they told to wear? Jeans and jeans. Let's see the difference. Most of the time these homophones makes us confused. Let's see. Now look at this pic. See, jeans, jeans. Jeans means what? The basic physical unit of inheritance. That's why, see, this baby it looks like her father and mother. Okay, like you also looks like your father and mother. Your eyes, otherwise your hair might be similar to your parents. Next pic, jeans, jeans. It's a type of clothes. Now what's the correct answer? Yes, jeans, jeans. Now let's see the next question, question number 10. He began to dash his bicycle fast as he was getting late. See here, pedal or pedal, which answer is correct? Let's see. Now look at this pic. Yes, the pic of pedal, P-E-D-A-L. It means it helps to control to your bicycle, means to move or to stop. Next pick, P-E-D-D-L-E, pedal. Pedal means the people who sells the goods by going place to place. It's called pedal. So which answer will be correct? Which option will be correct? So your correct option is P-E-D-A-L. Second one is correct. He began to pedal his bicycle fast as he was getting late. Now let's complete the spellings. Let's learn spellings. First, ordered, O-R-D-E-R-E-D. Second, treated, T-R-E-A-T-E-D. Third, fastened, F-A-S-T-E-N-E-D. Fourth, proclaimed, P-R-O-C-L-A-I-M-E-D. Proclaimed. Fifth, ensure, E-N-S-U-R-E. Sixth, limping, L-I-M-P-I-N-G. Limping. Seventh, justice, J-U-S-T-I-C-E, justice. Eighth, grapevine, G-R-A-P-E-V-I-N-E. Ninth, magnificent, M-A-G-N-I-F-I-C-E-N-T, magnificent. Tenth, prevailed, P-R-E-V-A-I-L-E, prevailed. Now let's learn kinds of nouns. First, proper noun. Second, common noun. Now let's learn about common noun and proper noun. Common noun, it is not capitalized and names any person, place or thing. Okay, whatever common nouns are there, they mostly comes in small letters. Means like for example, girl, boy. These words never starts with capital. Why? Because it is a common noun. Proper noun, name of a person, place or thing. Proper nouns are capitalized. These are the names. For example, Lucknow, Captain Sharma, Hindustan Times. These three are names and it starts with capital letters. L capital, C capital, H capital. Why? Because it's a proper noun. Its names are given for a particular thing or place or person. Now let's see the difference between common noun and proper noun. Common noun names any person, place, thing or idea. For example, my book is on the table. Here book is a common noun. Second sentence, the girl went to school early this morning. Here girl and school both are common nouns. Okay, these are common nouns. Why it is common noun? Because we can referring for any girl, any book, any school. For example, school is a common noun. Sihagad public school is a proper noun. Girl is a common noun. We can say any girl to girl, for example, American girl, Indian girl, like this. For example, Seema. Seema is a girl. So Seema is a name of particular girl. So Seema is a proper noun and girl is a common noun. Next, a proper noun names specific person, place, thing or idea. Examples, my book Long Walk to Freedom is on the table. Here, book is a common noun. But Long Walk to Freedom, it's the name given to that particular book. So it's a proper noun. Tamika goes to Caldwell Elementary. Tamika is the name of girl, so it's a Tamika. It's a proper noun. Caldwell Elementary, it's also particular name, so it's also proper noun.
What we have to do in this example, we have to underline the common nouns and circle the proper noun. See, first question, pizza, burger and noodles are all junk food. Here pizza, burger, noodles, these all are common nouns. Commonly we use these words. Second question, Aladdin and a magic lamp. Here Aladdin is a name of boy and magic lamp, it's a name of that lamp, magic. So circle it. Queen Elizabeth lives in Buckingham Palace in London. See here, Queen Elizabeth, it's a name given to that queen. Buckingham Palace, it's a name of place, and London, it's also name of place. So circle it, it's a proper noun. Fourth question, you can buy paints, pencils, papers and books from this shop. Okay, these all are common noun. There are variety of pens, are there variety of pencils, papers. You can say any pencil for pencil, any pen for pen, any book for like story book, textbook, maths book, Hindi book, like this. So underline it. Next question, fifth, Wednesday comes between Tuesday and Thursday. See here, these are the names of weeks, particular names are given, so it's a proper noun. Circle it. Next question, James and Alex work in an office in France. Okay, James, Alex, these both are names of persons, and see here, France is the name of country. So next, seventh one, Jupiter has several moons but Earth has only one. Here moons is a common noun, so underline it, and Jupiter and Earth, these all are proper noun, so circle it. Next question, eighth, the river Ganga starts from Gangotri. Here Ganga is the name of river, okay, and Gangotri is the name of place, so circle it. River is a common noun. As I explain, Ganga and Gangotri, see these both names are comes in capital, okay, those words are in capital, mostly they are in proper noun. Next question, Asima wanted to read A Gulliver's Travels but Shruti wanted to read Peter Pan. See here, the names of given like girls like Asmita and Shruti, so circle it. These are proper noun, particular names are given. Next one, Gulliver's Travels and Peter Pan, so these are the name of books, circle it. Next question, the Jog Falls in Karnataka, one of the highest waterfall in India. India is the name of country, so circle it. And waterfall is a common noun. Karnataka and the Jog Falls, these are also particular names are given, so circle it. It's a proper noun. Now let's solve question B. Write two proper nouns, each for the list of common noun given below. Question, festival. Here festival is a common noun, we have to write here two proper nouns like Holi and Diwali. Let's solve this question. See here, common nouns are given over here. We have to write the proper nouns. Festival, storybook, river, month, mountain, country, friend, favorite cartoon. These all are common noun. And we have to write two proper noun. Proper noun means what? Proper noun means noun which given to a specific person or place or thing. For example, festival. You can write any two festival names. Storybook. Any two storybook. Like this festival, we can mention here Holi, Diwali. Storybook, Panchatantra tells Tenali Raman. River, Ganga, Yamuna. Month, March, April. Mountain, Mount Everest and Makula. Country, India, America. Friend, Seema, Meera. Favorite cartoon, Doraemon and Pokemon. Now listening skill. Write opposite of the words given below. Justice, injustice. Fresh, stale or old. Old, opposite of it, young or new. Exit, entry or arrival. Dishonor, opposite, honor. Punishment, forgiveness. Unsuitable, suitable. Thanks for watching. Keep learning.